Hello, and welcome to River Point Church's training videos on Lakeside. There are two types of things that you'll generally do in Lakeside. You may have an event here where you have a speaker and some slides, or you may be dealing with overflow from the worship center. So if there are too many people for that, we have to get that service streaming in here, and then we'll put the extra people in here. We're gonna come over to the rack here and just power on the two power conditioners. There's this top one here, and then this red one down here. Once those are on, we can turn on the sound console, and that's got a button in the back. Where is it? Ah, right there. So it's a little flip knob, just like those. Flip that on. And then in the back left of the iMac here, there's a power button. You can just tap that. Generally, the computer will be asleep, so you just give it a quick tap and it'll wake up, but sometimes the computer may be off, in which case you might have to hold it down for a second or two for the computer to power on. Similarly to the console in the worship center, the console here has multiple fader groups that have different channels that you'll need to access depending on what you're going to be doing. In this case, in the first channel, or the first bank, which is channels 1 through 16, we have most of what you're going to be accessing. For example, two wireless microphones that you can use if you're having a speaker in here, and then also the sound from the iMac. So if you're going to be playing a video in ProPresenter or playing something off the DVD drive, you can access that audio from the first channel bank here. The only thing that you'll really need to access in the second bank of channels, which is 17 through 32, is if you are in the situation where you're using Lakeside as an overflow from the worship center, the audio from the worship center is on the second page of faders. To make sure your wireless microphones are working, before you even turn them on the console and get the channels going, you want to make sure that your wireless receivers are on. So if they're not on, you can just hit the gray power button on the right side of the unit. That will turn the screen on. And now you can come up to the console, unmute the channel, put the faders up, and you'll be able to hear it.